Chapter 1022, Bi Jianzhen, you. She couldn't help but grumbly stare at him. The Sleeping Dragon Cliff was an ancient and great sect in the Northern Grand Sea with immense resources and power. However, Li Kai made it sound as if it wasn't worth a single coin. However, Li Kai revealed a rare grin while looking at her to leisurely say, if you become my bed warmer, I can think about teaching you a little bit, less daydreaming. She glared at him and spoke with great dissatisfaction. Li Kai shrugged, this is you giving up on a godsent opportunity. He walked faster after saying so. Wo Longsun had no intention of giving up. She hastily followed and asked, where are we going to now? Li Kai didn't answer and continued on. She didn't mind and was right on his tail with a confident expression as if she was getting what she wanted. Eventually, Li Kai came before a huge temple and stopped to look at it. There were many worshippers in front of the temple. Some were prostrating on the ground, others were converting to Buddhism, and a few were kneeling and kowtowing 9 times to pay their respects. A group inside were offering incense. The more pious ones kneeled for a very long time with the intent of seeing a high monk. There was no lack of cultivators among them. In general, cultivators did not worship Buddhism, but things were different at the plateau. The weaker cultivators would be affected by the area and turn silly after staying here for a long time. They were affected by the Buddhist affinity in the air and would slowly give up everything to convert to Buddhism. In this place, their best choice for conversion was the Nalanta Temple or the other 18 temples under Nalanta, otherwise known as the Four Grand Void Tribulations. Not to mention Nalanta, even the other 18 temples were exceedingly difficult to enter. Even if one was a peerless genius or a powerful god king, they would still find this endeavor challenging. Without certain accomplishments on the Tao of Buddhism, the temples would not let them inside. However, if this was an impossible affair, then there were many other choices at the plateau due to the large quantity of temples. Thus, many chose to train in the other temples before attempting to join the 18 so that they would show some improvement. What are we doing? Wo Longsun asked after seeing Li Kai entering this temple. Scripture debate. Li Kai laughed as his Buddhist aura filled the air. His entire body immediately changed as if he had become an accomplished high monk. Afterward, Li Kai traveled to many temples. He chose famous and nameless ones on the plateau. After entering, he debated with the monks in these temples. However, rather than calling it a debate, it was more than preaching. Whenever he was listening to a Buddhist sermon or having a debate, he would often ask a difficult question that the other monks couldn't answer. It could be said that he convincingly defeated them with just one phrase. They candidly admitted their defeat and accepted his superiority in this aspect. Wo Longsun, who was following him the entire time, was quite shocked. It was not only because he only needed one word or one phrase to defeat his opponents. The scarier part was that all of his words and actions were meticulously in tune with the perfect Buddhist laws. It was just like he said before. He was Buddha. His words were Buddha's words. This was a very unnerving spectacle. One word to become a law, this was beyond imagination. There had been legends of holy monks turning into arhats and bodhisattvas once they reached the highest level. This group was capable of preaching laws with their words as well. However, in her eyes, Li Kai was most likely far above these arhats and bodhisattvas. His actions puzzled her quite a bit. Could it be that this Qiyunshin ahead was a real monk? Perhaps he really wanted to obtain enlightenment in the Buddhist Tao. However, her intuition was telling her that this matter was not so simple. After Li Kai continued on his visit to these temples, her puzzlement turned into astonishment. The whole journey was also a great trial for her because Li Kai's Buddhist affinity was becoming more and more powerful. It had a great impact on her Tao foundation. Even though he was not purposely doing so, her close proximity left her feeling this great power of conversion despite his attempt of containing it. She had no choice but to protect her Tao foundation with great caution. Otherwise, this Buddhist affinity would infiltrate her like mercury that could reach all corners and nooks. This made her even more determined to stay by his side. In her eyes, Li Kai was a very big test. He was a sharpening stone. His powerful Buddhist affinity could polish her Tao foundation. As a contemporary expert and a highly talented genius, Wo Longsu was able to protect her Tao foundation. However, this was not necessarily the case for other people. In recent days, Li Kai's travels to the great temples made it so that his Buddhist affinity was affecting many worshippers, especially the mortals and cultivators who wanted to convert Buddhism. Under this influence, they actually became his believers and followed him wherever he went. Even when Li Kai didn't preach to them or pass down any Dharma teachings, they were still converted by his aura. The number of followers increased continuously. Buddhism. This is far too scary. Wo Longsun was startled to see this. Even before any preaching, Li Kai was already able to gain so many followers. This type of power could only be described as demonic. If this wasn't the case, how do you think the Buddhist funeral plateau came to be? Li Kai chuckled. Buddhism has a far-reaching power. This is the difference between Buddhism and Taoism. Wo Longsun pondered for a moment. Buddhism was not cultivation. However, after reaching a certain level, especially one that resembles Li Kai's, the words of Buddhists would turn into laws. This was much more terrifying than what cultivators could do, even those at the virtuous paragon level. As they went on their way, many more experts and even paragons were present. Some of them were from famous imperial lineages. Of course, this type of crowd didn't come to worship Buddhism. Their presence, however, made this prosperous plateau even more lively. The arrival of these big shots caused many speculations to surface. The cultivators from the smaller sects didn't know why they were here. I heard a Buddhist kingdom is about to open. Some god kings will want to go on the pilgrimage. This rumor was spread across the plateau. A little bird told a crowd, it is not the opening of a Buddhist kingdom, it is someone ascending, a great holy monk. As long as he ascends, the Buddhist kingdom will naturally open. For many cultivators, even untouchable virtuous paragons, to be able to watch an ascension with their own eyes is a great fortune. There are many other benefits entailed with watching this event as well. Ascension. Many cultivators who wanted to convert Buddhism felt their hearts beating faster. One of them spoke, "Rumor has it that when a holy monk is ascending, they will cast everything away. At that time, someone who obtains the teachings and legacy of the holy monk would definitely be able to attain enlightenment in Buddhism." Many speculations spread across the plateau. The ascension made even more cultivators pour into this area because they all wanted the legacy just like in the legends. The majority of the younger generation came to the plateau in these last several days. The most brilliant among them were the Jewel Pillar Mortal King with the moniker of War Fanatic, Deity Ji Kong Wudi, and Zanshi from the Western Wasteland. The Mortal King had the greatest limelight with an unstoppable momentum at this moment. He once again defeated Wu Longsun, making him even more famous. Some even said that he was already above Ji Kong Wudi or at least on the same level as him. In fact, more and more people came to the plateau in droves besides this group. Among them were other brilliant geniuses. Bi Jianzhen was one of them. She came without great fanfare or domineering pomp. It was just her and the sword in her embrace. Her sword energy wasn't soaring and her demeanor wasn't cold and murderous. She changed quite a lot compared to the past. She had returned to the origin. Just like her name, she walked calmly and naturally as someone who was one with the world and myriad laws. Bi Jianzhen is here. Someone exclaimed after seeing her entering the plateau. It brought about quite a stir. The greatest sword user in the contemporary. Even a virtuous paragon from the previous generation had to concede this point. Someone speculated after seeing her. Why is she here? I think even the holy monk's legacy shouldn't be enough for her to come here from the Western Wasteland. Maybe it is because of Zanshi. A cultivator from the Western region added, her feud with Zanshi is not over. She lost to him last time, so maybe she wants to challenge him again. That could be true. Another spoke, they fought twice. Zanshi lost the first time and won the second. But now, her Tao of the sword is invincible, so she will definitely challenge him again. If that is the case, then she will probably win. A big shot murmured, her Tao of the sword has reached grand completion and can be described as invincible. Even the Mortal King doesn't dare to challenge her, HMPH, who says the war god doesn't dare to challenge Bei Jianzhen. His words made the Mortal King's supporters quite unhappy.